his gifts for creating moving television drama, Michael Landon brought to Little House his own unique sense of humor.
You know, in Little House, it was a dramatic television series, but you can definitely see in a lot of the episodes a lot of the fun-loving side of my dad. But there was also a quirkiness side to him. He was a huge practical joker.
People don't realize, but Michael was a very shy man. He covered it very well with his great sense of humor, his laugh, his sarcastic ways.
I thought you were all through your homework, haven't I?
Well, we're having a Bible quiz in Sunday school.
Oh, good. I'll ask you a few questions, see if you can answer them. Where do they mention baseball in the Bible?
Baseball?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know they played baseball in the Bible.
Mm-hmm. Very first line, Book of Genesis. In the beginning.
Charles. One of our favorite practical jokes that he would do is he loved putting things in his mouth. And there was a wonderful script lady who, she would be very focused on the lines, and my dad would bend down and, you know, like he was wanting to go over his lines with her, and she'd look up at him and he opened his mouth and a frog literally leaped out of his mouth onto her lap, which of course she screamed.
He's probably one of the funniest people that ever lived that I will ever know, and could make me fall down laughing daily, and did.
Neither one of us had too good a day, did we?
I really am sorry.
Me too.
If you got nothing to be sorry about, it was all my fault.
It was both our faults.
It was more my fault than it was your fault.
Well, it was my fault before it was your fault. I had the fight with Nellie, but that was her fault.
Well, then it's neither one of our faults. It's Nellie's fault.
Yeah, it's Nellie's fault.
If Landon's fellow cast members enjoyed sharing the screen with him, his crew was nothing short of devoted. A job on a Michael Landon show was considered one of the greatest gigs in Hollywood.
The crews, you'll never see a crew that's that loyal. I never worked with a crew like that again.
Michael Landon engendered a tremendous loyalty with his crew. These people would have walked through fire for Michael. They would have walked off cliffs for Michael. They would have done anything he asked them to do because he was incredibly loyal to them.
They all were family that had worked together for years and years and years and would work with no one else because working with Michael was such a pleasure because he cared for everyone and he had a deep, abiding respect and understanding for everyone's job on that set.
It was a place that everybody wanted to go to. There wasn't kind of that drudgery and that kind of sense of fatigue that you get, especially in the TV series work because it's such a grind. He never worked the crew long hours. I mean, nowadays, it's not uncommon to be working, you know, 14-hour days.
We would work a 12-hour day. That was our schedule, whether it was to the studio or local location. But for instance, Spike on a Monday night would say to the crew after lunch, he'd say, you know, there's a hell of a ball game on tonight. He says, I want to get home by 6 o'clock to see it. So he says, I'll give a little if you give a little. And we would wrap around 4.
He really was efficient with his time and running a set that, even though there was time for laughter and having fun, but he, at the end of the day, wanted everyone to be able to go home to their families.
It stems from Michael's ability to know what he wanted as a director before he ever got to the stage. If he wrote a script or read a script, he knew how it was going to be edited and what it should look like. So there was no waste motion. We used less film than any show in Hollywood.
Michael understood the camera. He understood lenses. He understood editorial. He knew what he was trying to achieve and understood the process. And he didn't leave it to anybody. I mean, Michael cut the show and the camera.
He was clearly demanding. He demanded that we know our lines, that I know my lines. He demanded that I, you know, be on time, that I hit my marks. But he was very nurturing and warm.
Know what it means when a person gets jealous?
Well, sure I do. I was jealous that time that Almanza was going with that snippy Christy.
Why do you suppose you were?
Well, I know why. Because I love Almanza and... Oh, Pa. Do you think that Almanza could be in love with me?
I don't know for sure.
But what do you think?
I think it's a darn good chance.
The two men who brought the stories of Laura Ingalls Wilder to television shared a love for simple tales of family life on the American frontier. From Ed Friendly, the New York kid who fell in love with the West.
Everything that the West represented resonated with him as it did with Laura Ingalls Wilder in terms of his own childhood.
To Michael Landon, the Hollywood veteran who yearned to heal his own past by showing the world what a happy family could be.
I think my dad was really excited about what this series could do for the public. And I think he knew that the public was hungry for something wholesome, something that really pushed family values in a positive way.
Good night, Pa.
Good night, sweetheart.
He had the touch to make people cry, to touch their hearts, and to move them.
Where does the time go?
These days, to be able to do the things that he did and to bring in the audiences that he did and to teach the lessons and give them the stories that they wanted to see for as many years as he did is a tremendous achievement.
They captured what Laura wrote in her books.